Suspension is meaning all the activities on site are frozen, but all the resources we have, in particular human resources, are present on site, but on standby.
Luca De Maria, CMC Revana project manager, says the delayed payments of the invoices are not only affecting this construction work. Approached for comment, Roads Authority Chief Executive Officer Konrad Lutombi had said his office is aware of the delayed payments and that the company is doing all it could to settle all outstanding invoices. About a week ago, over 100 employees downed tools and marched to the CMC Otesa Joint Venture offices in Okahanja demanding the immediate payment of their December overtime. The workers, among other issues, questioned why the company, according to them, did not want to pay them for the hours worked. They accused management of installing a new timekeeping equipment, which at times does not reflect accurate hours. De Maria, while emphasizing that the workers' actions were illegal, attributed the delay in overtime payments to the newly installed timekeeping system, AfriClock.
In this particular case, and the fact that this one happened at the beginning of the year was simply because something that was booked and calculated in December, because we had to pay the people by the 18th. The 18th of December day was the last working day. Of course, the calculation of the wages was done by the 10th of December. So between the 10th and the 9th and the 18th was forecasted, the presence and the overtime.
The payment of the workers started yesterday. The joint venture has defended the AfriClock system, saying with proper training on how to correctly use the system, these errors will be a thing of the past. While training is ongoing, the joint venture will make use of both the manual and computerized systems to ensure accurate timekeeping. The AfriClock system will be fully implemented in March. Emil Seibeb, NBC News, Windhoek.